We're going to be talking primarily about heart valve disease today, but let's put that in perspective, because the heart valves are just one component of the heart that have to work normally. We can think of the heart as having four different systems that all have to function normally together at the same time. Let's call the first one the electrical system, and it tells the upper chambers when to lub and the lower chambers when to dub. In synchrony like this, so that the heart can function in a normal manner. There is also, since the heart is a muscle, it consumes oxygen, and it has to have nutrients and oxygen, and it has its own set of arteries that carry oxygen-rich blood to the heart muscle, divide continuously, insinuating their way through the heart muscle, and feed every cell. Those are called the coronary arteries. And if those get blockages in them, well, you know what happens. You get a heart attack in that area, or, fancy word, the myocardial infarction. The muscle itself can be thought of as one of the systems, and it is the power supply. It is what's squeezing. It's providing the force to propel the blood, and it does that synchronously, upper chamber, lower chamber, upper chamber, lower chamber. But if we didn't have something to divide them and direct that blood flow, then it's just going to slosh back and forth. And that's where the valves come in. The heart contains four valves, two valves that divide the upper chambers from the lower chambers, and then valves that divide the lower pumping chambers on the right side from the lungs and the left side from the body. Heart valve disease occurs primarily in two of the valves, and they're the valves on the left side of the heart. The mitral valve, which is between the left atrium and the left ventricle, and the aortic valve, which is between the left ventricle and the aorta, or the main artery out to the body. We do get disease in the right-sided valves, but not very often, and frequently it is only secondary to disease that occurs in the left-sided valves.